going on, guys? Beastly Gamer here. Welcome to the channel. Today's video is about Nintendo. And Nintendo's a company that I love, but at the same time I hate. I feel like half of them is... I just feel like they're a Jekyll and Hyde kind of company. Half of the company is very endearing and I love. The other half is a company that I don't feel truly understands modern media, social media, things like YouTube. I don't feel like Nintendo really understands exactly what these applications are for and how people use them. With that being said, Nintendo has taken it upon themselves to flag a YouTuber for using the sound from the Nintendo Switch. Yes, here we go again. And you guys can probably guess, even though I own a Nintendo Switch, you'll probably never see Nintendo footage on my YouTube channel. But I will drop a link in the description. Nintendo flags YouTube user for using Switch sound. YouTubers who feature Nintendo games and products have long had issues with YouTube's controversial content ID system, and Nintendo's aggressive usage of that system is already impacting how YouTubers cover games on the Switch. Recently, a YouTuber had their video flagged by YouTube's content ID system over a sound effect from a Switch launch game. YouTube's content ID system is an automated system that allows copyright holders to place claims on videos who use their content. In theory, Content ID prevents piracy and allows copyright holders to make money off their own work. In practice, YouTubers who make videos under fair use end up having to fight an automated system to protect their content. Josh Thomas has been covering Nintendo for the past decade on his YouTube channel, The BitBlock. He recently had a video about 1-2 Switch flag over sounds from the game, a music track from the game, and a man saying, quote, "ready, fire," end quote, from the Quick Draw minigame. The former is not surprising. YouTubers know that music tracks often get dinged, and videos can be flagged for even a few seconds of a trailer. In this case, having specific sound effects set the system off is quite unprecedented, but feels quite extreme as well. According to Thomas, the content ID troubles aren't helped by the fact that Nintendo's affiliate program causes YouTubers to split profits from any video using footage of their games with Nintendo itself. YouTubers like Thomas find themselves in a hard spot when trying to cover Nintendo. Quote, "The workaround here involves nearly completely muting the game music in the background, or flipping and altering the color in any trailer footage used. It all makes for a complicated process, and in the end I feel forces me and others to create purposely inferior video content for no real reason." To clarify, this video in question, amongst hundreds of others in the past, is actually well within fair use. The video shows us physically demonstrating 1-2 Switch, adding our own silly commentary on camera, and is edited quite a bit. It isn't merely a matter of gameplay being uploaded without any kind of transformative work put into it," end quote. Thomas insists that he still loves Nintendo, but like many YouTubers who cover the company, he is clearly frustrated. Quote, "Essentially what I'm saying is, Nintendo, please stop hurting me. Please stop trying to stop me from celebrating you as a company," end quote. The Nintendo Switch comes with a built-in feature to take screenshots of games, but unlike its console competitors, does not have the ability to record and share video on social media. It seems that for the time being, Nintendo is not ready to play nice with YouTube just yet. And that's my major, major problem with Nintendo as a company. They don't seem to grasp that YouTube is actually a benefit, a net benefit to them as a company. If people are afraid to show your footage, if people are afraid to show images from your games, if people can't even have sounds from a game that you create on their YouTube channel while they play it, and even in something like 1-2 Switch, that's totally insane. Because you don't even see the game. You only see the people. Nintendo, it's very frustrating. It's a huge overreach. And ultimately, in the end, it's going to hurt them. I feel like as time goes on, Nintendo's going to have to understand. They're going to come around. It's going to be sooner or later. They're going to come around to the fact that they've got to take a step back on their very Orwellian YouTube content ID policy. It's just ridiculous. People who go through hours and hours making Nintendo content are very likely to have it stricken from them and have all their monetary benefits taken away by Nintendo and even possibly have their YouTube channels closed down with multiple content ID strikes. I'm staying far away from Nintendo. I mean, I'll play the games here at home. I won't show any footage because Nintendo is just it's like the yellow question block on the Mario games. You don't know what you're gonna get. You know, I played Smash Brothers last year, and Nintendo immediately content ID striked me, and I couldn't believe it. That was the last time, and I love playing Bayonetta 2, these games, and now I got the Nintendo Switch, but I'll never put it on this YouTube channel until Nintendo comes out officially and says, hey, look, we're going to stop being dickheads and let you guys play our games on YouTube. You guys let me know what you think about Nintendo and their Orwellian YouTube policies in the comments below. Be sure to give a thumbs up, show support for the channel, join the Facebook group, follow me on Twitter, share your videos, and support the channel at beastlygamer.com. I'm the Beastly Gamer, and I'll see you guys next time. Let it go. 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 Let it go